We're preparing to fight Ifrit. Again. Let's get my Chocobo. That'll be my true focus today, is getting mount privileges so I can use my mount. Okay, here we go again. Dead people. Sweet! Because, like, I don't have mount privileges yet because game says no. you may not be a noob. Oh, wait, hold on. I don't want to be tagged as a noob in this one. It was nice on my primal, but not on here. Ah, look. Ripe corpses. My favorite thing to carry. You sense a hostile presence. Gasp. Things trying to kill me. Unexpected plot twist. So now that I looked at the digest of the live letter, I got a bit more clear look at the translation. They're taking out 13% of our realm of Boyne. And they were right, that may not seem like a lot, but they are, depending on which path you take, because one of them has 3 more quests than the other. They're either, in total, if you add in patch content, they're either 285 quests in Realm of Born or 288. It honestly, it depends on which one. I don't remember which one has more, but one of the openings has a bit more. Actually, maybe Lives. No, it could be Ilda. I don't think it's good on you. Who knows? That doesn't matter. But they're taking out 13% of the patch content. So technically, I suppose if you do the math here, we'll do... What was this, 2 days? They're taking out 37 quests. Which is actually a lot of probably what is the majority of that stupid shitty fetch slash go here quest done content. I like hearing what poor people think, because that's the name of this quest. Some being cut to make it less. Exactly. Patch content will be less of a shit, but it won't matter because I'll be past patch content anyway. Feels bad. I will definitely appreciate they reworked it because they were like, it was really expensive, and that's what Yoshi just said. PC who definitely won't be shit later. Oh, I just want to write a joke about again, Christ. But hey, fair. How are you today? Gotta go fast. Ah, hello, man who is definitely not important later. Is it up? I forgot. I believe it's up. Well, I'll really be out here just carrying corpses. Thank you. Ha 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 ha. I learned absolutely nothing like the good person I am. Ah, yes, useless scion number one. For the children! Yeah! Alright, we're going up there. Yay! Adventure! I also got a rock, did you? Hey, children! Gasp, the very person we're looking for has gone off. What a wonderful coincidence. Wow, look, we saved her. Gasp. You know what? I'm really lazy. I'm just gonna teleport. Yeah, an innocent person for sure. It's all good. I'm all the wrong places. Ha ha ha. Oh right, now we have to go see Thankfully again. Ahem, adventure, yay! Oh, right, I get to go look inside. Well, Thankry just chills outside. What a wonderful plan. Let Pengu take care of everything. A good plan, I must say. Don't mind me. I'm just coming. Yeah, I knew you were gonna find me. Wee wee, it's the Pengu police. No. I mean, if it still wants to fight me over here, sure. It's just gonna die, but okay. Look, Thankard, I'm being useful. Well, if only you could say the same. I'm still lazy. The plot thickens, indeed. We have a fake church member, gasp. No unusual activity. Gas. Okay. Let us play as victims, because that'll be fun. We're impoverished souls, indeed. I mean, I truly am. Rolls on the ground. Have you seen me, Thankred? Time to play the role of poor person, quite literally. Is it acting, if it's true? Definitely a noob. Definitely a poor person in need of sucker here, yep. I need work. You Excuse me, do you happen to have work? Anchored, there's a pond. You have quite a knack for being a nuisance. Thank you. Thanks, I think. Thanks, I think. Look at us poor people. Fine evening for catching false priests, wouldn't you say? Absolutely. Now, a smart person would tell Rip Thancred's tattoo, the Archon symbol, that he's clearly not meant this. Ha, got him. If I sacrifice some people, then my place will be okay. Gee, look at that. We're angry. Then blame yourselves or the gods. Ooh, everyone likes to make that noise. It's me. What a sob story. Oh no, not prayer return to the waking sands. Not a prayer return to the waking sands moment. Then I have to immediately come back here.
Wait. Let's see if I remember this correctly. Then it's the materia thing, isn't it?
I forgot. It is. Gotcha. Let's make sure my XP is still good. But then again, there are a lot of 20 quests. In comparison. So we'll be fine. I'm hitting a rock again. Gosh darn it. Right, return to the Waking Sands. It is E3 next, yeah? Yeah, just to receive life material and everything and then go to the Inferno. I'm tiny, Tataru. Just happy with Anchor and I are getting along. Dude, the Anchor's totally chill right now. He's not possessed. I just guessed on my own voice. Is it in Central? It is in Central, that's right, because it's up there. It's great. That XP bar is really close to leveling. I'm like semi-bothered, but it's fine. materia, dudes. Material, dudes. Right, return to the Waking Sands. materia. Just materia things. Lord of the Inferno! Thankard is busy attending another matter. Convenient. I must admit, that's convenient. Let's beat up Ifrit again. It's on the other side of the wall, yeah. Indeed. Let's beat up Ifrit! I mean, not yet, but after this duty, let's beat up Ifrit. We've been bamboozled. Bamboozled again. Unexpected plot twist. Doubt. Oh no, whatever will we do?
Oh
trying to remember when it auto finishes itself. Entertaining as this is, are we done yet? I really think we just want to put in the free part. So I can watch many, many cutscenes because it's a long ass cutscene. I'm a big kid now. Time already, sweet. Oh no, 10 p.m. already. My mom is going to kill me. Ah, look, I'm alive again. The Bowl of Ember is now accessible. Is there a dude in the queue? Oh, I got you, dude. Let me go queue for it. You're still hoping it blessed him. I got you. Hopefully it was him. It was gonna be an instant for me because I'm a healer. God, this painfully long cutscene. Bum bum, Lord of the Inferno. Rawr. What a pretty boy. Look at that, being a traitor doesn't pay off in the end, now does it? Haha, look, I live. Take that. 1v1 me, bro. Yoink, I'm already another person. Gee, it's almost like Heidelin. Hath claimed me. He's just an angry ifwee. I thought it was 24. Used to be able to stun that. It was actually kind of funny. You could stun him right before. So there it is. It's done. Ifrit, oh god. But can be stunned! I know they could stun on this one. Look, it's a crystal, my favorite. I think it is late as ever, but still appears. Yay! Takes out one of them, therefore he's not useless, right? I've been given a baptism of fire, but yet I'm okay. And yet I'm fine. That is a consideration for another time. Yeah, you guys are useful for the whole duration of this, right? Absolutely not. Oh yeah, I'm still in the duty, GG. Yay, a free teleport. Thank God has been forgiven. Return to the Wicking Sands. But soon we can take him out, so it'll be less terrible. Okay, once again, give me a quick second. Cool. And in I go. That face still. I think it's like, man, I suck. Yada yada, primals, my dude. Primals, my dudes. Primals and crystals and ether. Primals. The echo is so handy. yada yada breaks, but I just want my Jacobo. Ah, yes, we killed the tempered people. And then Thancred becomes possessed like an idiot. Or not quite yet. I don't know when he gets. Ah, oh, yes, a hero in the making. I bested a primal, absolutely did it. Nailed it. I get to join a useless grand company. Grand companies have lost any and all use, for they were really meant for determining your PvP team. But because Freelancer is on, it doesn't matter anymore. Ah, as I can see, I get to do, they've all been sent, yay. Looking at you, Tataru. Master Keyblader. I love my name. Blinks in confusion. Yeah, I already know what the grand companies are, and they're useless now. A fine suggestion. Oh my gosh, I can meet the kiddos officially now. What if I don't want to join one? Unfortunately, you have to, and it has no use anymore.
Can you just join Lipsa? Because Lipsa's pirates, and pirates are cool.
I want a chocobo. I especially should do good to Anya because I should rep whoever I started, shouldn't I? I could just transfer into them, so because pirates are cool. I mean, truthfully, it no longer has a use because it really was just for PvP. Because that was how you determined your teams, you determined it by a grand company, but because they turned freelancer on for everything now. It has no use. Basically says you can go in whatever order you want. How convenient. Let's meet the kiddos that I've sworn to protect because I'm protecting them. But they are the just innocent. There are like five kiddos. Four kiddos that I'm protecting. Definitely say you're gonna count high and green.
I lost my son to the Calamity.
The three seed seers are all together.
Some say you couldn't take a step without stumbling over a body.
That was Cartano for you, quite literally. Where are the kiddos? Where they at?
Our forebears were once strangers in the Twelve's Wood.
They sure heckin' were.
Fearful of the Green Wrath, they hid themselves in the dark recesses of the earth. yet they dreamed of basking in the dappled sunlight of the forest. Through great effort, they proved their worth to the elementals, and were granted a place beneath the boughs. So it was that Gridania was born, some 5 centuries ago. Working hand in hand, the Hure and the Elizan settlers sowed the seeds of our civilization, and soon they were joined by folk of all races.
How nice.
So nourished by the waters of unity and blessed by the light of the matron, Gridania flourished into the great nation it is today.
What's up, kiddos? See the Gridanian standard? Self-assured there, youth, my boy. Behind the elder Seedseer. My boy. My boy.
The serpents represent the unity between Hure and Elizan. An elegant symbol, do you not agree?
Indeed, oh so elegant.
In accordance with the will of the elementals, we have embraced a life of peace. Alas, our neighbors have not always sought the same for themselves. Nor for us. Though we Gridanians have no love for war, we have still less for those who would threaten our way of life. Ever have we fought to protect the sanctity of the Twelve's Wood. When the Garlean Empire brought its war of conquest to Eorzea, we rallied under the noble standard of the Twin Adder, that we might push back the encroaching darkness. And it was we who prepared the ground for the reformation of the Eorzean Alliance, that all the peoples of this realm might stand united against the common threat. Five years ago, the Alliance met the armies of the Empire upon the fields of
Cardinal. On that day, 5 years ago.
It would prove the bloodiest battle in recent memory. Countless Gridanian lives were lost. As
Countless
Supreme
lives
Commander
were lost.
Of the Order of the Twin Adder, ever shall I bear the weight of our people's sacrifice. Alas, their loss was not the only tragedy to befall us that day, for soon came the calamity.
Oops, wrong button.
The scars borne by our forest are a constant reminder of its violence. Our lives have been irrevocably changed, each waking hour a struggle to survive. Driven to desperation, some among us have strayed from the path of righteousness, resorting to banditry, poaching, and other unconscionable deeds. To compound our woes, the Ixel
My boy.
Have returned in force, emboldened by our suffering. They
Can I
test
hug
our
him?
Defenses,
and of course
without Ellie's cease, and prey
Can I hug
upon
the kiddos?
Vulnerable.
I know we don't really know each other
so
yet, but
beleaguered from within and without, it is of little wonder that our unity now falters. Dark times are upon us.
Time was a man could
the
walk the high roads without fear.
On this day, 5 years ago,
on the day
countless Eorzeans laid
me.
Down their lives. That we might behold another dawn. Please join with me in honoring their memory.
And how do you propose to honor the memory of those
God,
you
I
cannot
can
remember?
Remember. Still, good point. Cynical girl. Girl. That is like the one time she looks at you, then she looks away.
The destruction wrought by the calamity was indiscriminate. It dealt death to Eorzean and Garlean alike. Yet while we have labored to rebuild our homes, to rebuild our lives. The Empire has set
this is
about
what you get for sharing
raising
a border with
steel
the Empire.
Fortresses here in the Twelves Wood.
Let Maybe we should free all of Amigo.
The Garleans remain the greatest threat to our survival. If we are to stand against them, we must remember what it is to be united.
Let's go free all Amigo now.
Our
Take care of your border.
Blind us to the woes of our fellow man. Thence is harmony lost. Yet harmony is the founding principle of Gridania. We are gathered here to honor the fallen. Let them be honored not only in word and thought, but through concerted action. I bid you join hands with me once more beneath the Twin Adder standard. And together, let us heal the forest's wounds, that our progeny might live in harmony beneath these ancient boughs. For serenity, purity, and sanctity. We must think of the children!
Woods will be done!
It's
yeah.
up
to us to protect the forest!
All the elementals!
Boyo and girl, the kiddos, introduce yourselves so I can hug you.
If you'll permit me, Alfino.
Alfino, my boy, and Alize.
And my sister, Alize, at your service.
She just straight up refuses to look at you, and I love it.
I saw at a glance that you were a fellow traveler.
She refuses to look
you
at
might
you.
Call us students of history, sampling the realm's remembrances in pursuit of enlightenment.
Garuda and the sylphs have Ramu, but sylphs are sylphs and they don't really summon Ramu. Don't worry, boy. I'll join the tree lovers. And then if I feel like it, I will transfer myself to pirate. Bye, kiddos. See you in a minute.
himself!
And Roban as well!
Look, it's Roban with two arms.
Hark, you
Star can resist.
Fame, drawn to the bosom of the desert, where the fire burns brightest and shall rage forevermore. Hurrah! Roban! Where since antiquity, under the sage and judicious rule of the Ul Dynasty, we have wrought sand into gold. Where by the grace and glory of Nal'thar, have our brave sons and daughters flourished and prospered? I speak of Uldar!
There.
Hey, kiddos.
At the Flame General's back flies the
I miss you so much.
Standard. Note the sigil. The golden scales of order.
Boy, he's just nerding out right now, and I love him so much.
Great and many are the gifts our nation has given the realm. In Eorzea's darkest hour, on the killing fields of Cartano, none spent more in blood and gold than we.
Doubt.
Thus was the 7th Imperial Legion laid low.
But you didn't kill them. Muhammad did.
So that's how it happened. How soon history forgets.
Indeed, my boy. Try not to focus on the
Yet
big
many
needs.
Left our gates, never to return.
They're all dumb and all think they were the winners.
Let us pray for our absent brothers and sisters, that they might know happiness in the great beyond, as Thal's honored guests. If the fates were fair, the price we paid that day would have bought us victory. Alas, they are not. And now, but 5 years into this 7th Umbral era, the spirit of sacrifice which granted us our strength is all but dead. Look around you. What do you see? A people divided, downtrodden, and enthralled. Where are the merciful alms of the rich? Where is the just steel of the righteous? I ask you, is this the great nation our brothers and sisters gave their lives to save? You, who call this living, dishonor the name of the immortal flames. It is but a slow death. Our enemies surround us. The savage hordes of the Amalja wait beside our roads, strangling the lifelines of trade.
Yada yada, rub on, talk faster. I'm already joining the tree people.
The Garlians make mock of our borders and despoil our land of its natural wealth.
I'm just here to spend time with the children.
We stand on a precipice, yet we do not act. Whether trader or soldier, monetarist or royalist, all must recognize that a divided Uldar stands to fall. Victory and fortune walk hand in hand. Ye who seek glory and wealth, look not to what little you can snatch from your neighbor, but to the boundless wealth of the world beyond. Now is the time to unite. Now is the time to ride forth. In the name of the Sultana, I beseech you. Line not your own coffers, but those of the immortal flames. Seek not to prosper from Uldar, but to restore her to prosperity. As the realm prospers, so shall Uldar. As Uldar prospers, so shall her people.
They all just care about money.
For Uldar.
Together we are one.
Your grace.
Rabban.
People of Uldar, I now
Dynamo, 17th in the line of all, address you. Much has been made of the wealth of Uldar.
God, I hate it.
Yet those who measure that wealth in coins and carrots are gravely deceived. For the true wealth of Uldar lies in the health, happiness, and hopes of her people. Beloved subjects, I bid you raise aloft the torch of Uldar, that her flames might serve as a beacon for all Eorzea to see.
Long live Nanamo!
Bap, bap, bap. Yay!
Victory and fortune! Stride fearless into the inferno, for we are by fire reborn! Forsooth!
The time is now!
I believe!
Fancy meeting you again, my boy. And at least he still refuses to look at me. Get out! I'm just kidding. It's fine. Speaking of Ifrit, boy, I'm the one that just defeated it. Did you pay your lucky distaste? So I trust you even counted them. And more, boy. And more. The Gorliads still exist. At least Ace faces just me. Me. Just staring like a dead person. Like me. Just no emotion. And boy, I have no intention of joining them. But thanks for sharing, boy. And now he's always like, okay, I'm out of here. Which I felt that, kiddo. Before I forget, I know I am definitely making Uldar a favorite, or not the Limsa, because I am always a Limsa.
Garlians are another matter altogether.
So much for our alliance.
It's sunk beyond the seabed.
Brothers and sisters of the sea, hearken unto me. Look upon this, our mighty crimson standard, and tell me your hearts do not swell with pride. Seven 700 summers have come and gone since our forefathers first ran aground in this fertile bay.
Speech.
In that time, guided by the Mother of Oceans, Limsa Lominsa has grown from humble fishing village to uncontested ruler of the five seas and beyond.
Did you look as the Admiral bid you? It is a rather stirring standard, I must say. The crimson field is meant to signify the blood of fallen crewmates, while the black longship represents a pirate vessel.
When the Galleon Empire marched upon Eorzea, we assembled beneath the Maelstrom Standard, and our grand company was reborn. All answered the call, from the Knights of the Barracuda to Hilthir's bloody executioners. And together, we met our would-be conquerors upon the field of Cartano. That day, the world bore witness to the united strength of Limsa Lominsa. Swear to you, no army ever fought harder or with more courage. Yet many of ours did not survive.
Yada yada.
Join me now in remembering those who fought in the name of freedom and fell. May their souls be returned to the sea.
Freedom. Yes, they have always been rather fond of their freedom. Much as the beast tribes have. Small wonder. Beneath the surface, one
call
would struggle boy. To tell them
call
apart.
Call them out, boy! Beast tribes also want to be free!
It has been 5 long years since the calamity struck. 5 long years of tireless rebuilding. Yet still, the wounds of the Calamity fester and weep. But when I stand atop the mizzenmast and gaze out upon our battered and broken vessel, I see an undying spirit. Did we not build all this from the wreck of the Galadian all those centuries ago? Shall we not do so again? Yet there are those who would see this ship of ours sink beneath the waves of the restless Rotano. The Sahagin creep ashore seeking blood for their accursed god.
Blood for the blood god!
Those fishback
the
bastards!
The Sahagin have risen?
While the mines of Ogomoro spew forth kobolds who push ever south, despoiling our lands as they go. These savage beast tribes will be the first waves to crash against our creaking hull. And behind them swells the grim tide of the Galleon Empire. Even now, the Kurs fly their flags within our borders. Doubt not, but that they will be upon us ere long. We are well nigh surrounded. Yet there are those among us who would rather turn their swords against their crewmates than our cannons against our foes. How can we hope to repel our many enemies when mutiny breeds below deck? There is but one course left to us. One bearing that will bring us victory over the Beast Hordes and the Empire both, and see this ship safe to port. We must mend the rift the Calamity has reopened twixt Pirate and Maelstrom, and stand fast with our adventurer brothers against the coming tempest. Mark ye well, a crew without unity is no crew at all. 'Tis but a mass of drowned men. To
speeches.
Me, then, brothers and sisters of the sea, gather beneath the undying crimson standard and pledge me your strength, your skill, your wisdom. And with the guidance of the Navigator, this great vessel of ours shall ride the waves till sea swallows all.
Long live the Admiral!
And the Mervin!
Gather the lads!
Oh, where's me cutlass?
I'll follow you to the Seven Hells, Admiral!
Fancy meeting you again.
Fancy meeting you again, best boy. What for the blood god? Boy, I can't wait for you to be in the plot. I'm joining the tree people, unfortunately. This is what I decided, because it doesn't matter anymore. What a coincidence. Private time doesn't make sense. Right, return to the Waking Sands. Oh my gosh, I can almost take my check episode.
Go, go, go! Or my chocobos. God, I hated that stupid mid-range mission that they're doing right now. God, I hated that one. So, so stupid. This one. Were that there were more of you. If only there were like five of me, that would be great, wouldn't it? Yes, meanwhile with the kiddos.
The gods only know what grand company our adventurer friend will keep.
Friends already, sweet.
The wheels of change are in motion regardless.
Brother, are you certain this course is best?
Whatever do you mean, dear sister?
The so-called remembrance ceremonies were little more than standard waving rallies.
Mood.
As though the Calamity and Seventh Umbral Era warranted scarcely a mention.
Sorry, your grandfather doesn't get mentioned and
well,
you guys are losing.
Of course they were standard waving rallies.
Kiddos, I love you.
Since you are so observant, mayhap you noticed what mention was made of the Warriors of Light? None. I suppose they must have forgotten the heroes who spared Eorzea a fate worse than the Calamity? No, dear Alizé, they haven't forgotten these details. They have elected to omit them. Deep are the wounds the Calamity inflicted upon Eorzea. So deep, in fact, that the realm still bleeds. Needless to say, the beast tribes and their primals do little to alleviate the pain. So, the task of salving Eorzea's wounds falls to the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, with a little help from our friends, the Grand Companies. Remembrance will yield no remedy. If our world is to heal, we must put the horrors of the calamity behind us.
Our grandfather would never entrust the fate of the realm to despots who rewrite history to their convenience.
Alfino is just like, okay, sure.
There must be another way to cure what ails this world, and I mean to find it.
Sure.
You are most welcome to try. Our paths may differ, but our destination is the same. In time, I dare say we will see eye to eye.
Bless the kiddos, they only try their best.
My lady!
We are to escort you!
Hope does not come into it. We share the burden of this fate, dear sister, and will prevail together or not at all. The salve will serve not only to close up our present wounds, but prevent old ones from opening anew.
Kiddos, my boy and girl. Protect! Okay, I said I would join the tree people. Therefore, I must join the tree people. Sure. The only one I haven't done yet is this one, so sure. Bye, Manfilia. I am here to enroll. Weep boop, I'm Pangu. Let's go. How convenient, I'm needed. Let's go. That's surprising. I knew it was gonna be something. Okay, hold up. Time to fight. That was interesting. I didn't know that, but... Wait, look, we have Bailstar as well. Look, it's Bailstar as well. I find myself cornered. Oops. I usually get so cornered. I had a feeling I would. Look, it's the Battlestar Fall! Let's find some cover. Hides behind a tree, I'm sure. Oof, look at that. Let's get the ship. Let's go. Go team. And the might of the Empire, dude. Sure. We're like fighting right next to the Balesaur's wall though, so I suppose, yeah, this is not unexpected. Yes, chocobo time soon. Thank you. We did it. We've rescued Big Sin Wedge. Look, it's Balestar as well. We did it. Let us be inducted to the tree people. Woohoo! The oath. Tree people. Tree people. Tree people. I can have my chocobo after this, guys. I am ready for my chocobo. Pray, return to the Waking Sands at your earliest convenience. Registration. I can still have registration. Check it out. Hang on, let me go finish the quest. Let me go finish the quest first. Check it out. I can soon write them out. We only have to run one more time. Then I can take my mounts. I return to the Waking Sands. Ah, look, friends. Let me see if I was at your adventurer, who's a scient and a serpent. Golly, how do you keep track of everything? I must be pairing up with lots of different people than me. I'm always with Papa Lima. Come to think of it, why am I always with Papa Lima? Huh, Lise? I don't know. You tell me. I'm putting my skills to use. Yay! Biggs and Wedge. Friendship. I just want my chocobo. We get to be the keepers of the technology because we're neutral. Yeah! Thank you. What is happiness but an illusion?
Having set aside the formalities,
except
we have a favor to ask of you.
Please don't ask anything of me.
Uriange, have the documents arrived from the students of Baldessian?
Aye, my lady. They arrived but recently.
We have conducted a study at the behest of the Order of the Twin Adder. Papalimo, Ida, a synopsis.
Yes, explain the next part of the plot.
Our task was to survey the behavior of the Sylphs, a beast tribe indigenous to the Twelveswood.
Oh, how to describe them. They look like Gisselgreens, floating ones that worship the primal Ramu.
Though technically a beast tribe, Sylphs are blessed with a comparatively personable demeanor, conducive to peaceful communication.
Offering us an invaluable opportunity to learn what the beast tribes know of the primals.
Yay!
While Ramu's existence is well documented, the Sylphs do not, or perhaps cannot, summon the primal any longer, insofar as can be ascertained, until such time as we know. It would be unwise to assume that the threat posed by the primal has passed.
Which leaves Gridania with the added worry of not knowing what they should be worrying about.
In that regard, they are hardly alone. What we can say with absolute certainty is that Gridania has its hands full fending off Garuda, who,
primal,
I need hardly remind you, is among the most savage and terrible Garuda of all
is the worst.
Primals.
Then we're all weak if Garuda
is
the worst.
It is essential that we approach the Sylphs
right,
in as diplomatic a manner as
possible. Wait, we need Afino, the diplomat boy.
Words and actions can be misconstrued. The only sure way to communicate our intentions is the Echo. Winning the Sylph's favor may well bring us a step closer to mitigating the threat of the primals. Will you help us? I am grateful.
Lovely. Well, as much as I'd like to help, I'm afraid I would be of little use to anyone in Gridania. Of Ida and Papalimo, however, should be able to see the forest for the trees. Is that not so, Minfilia?
Indeed. You are willing?
Let's go have fun with the Sylphs. Yay!
Us, Ida! Us!
Lise and Papalimo time. Yay! See, convenient. I was gonna have to go back to Gardania anyway. Nailed it. Hang on. Let me get my chocobo thing. Chocobo! Chocobo, chocobo, chocobo. Give me authorization or use him out! Oh, it needs a name. It needs a name. Shit, I need a name. I need a chocobo name. Shit. Do I just take my old one and use Quetzalcoatl? Ahem. The one I kind of took off of. Okay, my chocobo is mine. I can do it! I can ride mounts! I can ride my two mounts! Yay! Finally! At last! I can ride the mount! Hang on, I'll use the whistle to get the regular one too. I can ride the draught and the mount and our carb. Finally, at last, I can use a mount. I am a part of the Scions and I'm gonna just do this next one, yeah? I can use a mount, guys. It's all good now. We're all sober. Sorry to disappoint, but we're also they just magically appeared. I saw that. Let's go see the sylphs. beastmen, we'll be beastmen. Hmm. This should be as easy as it is. Doubt. I can take my... I already hit the easy right there. I can use that. Ouch! Real suffer. Oh shit, I need it level 30 for PvP, that's right. Real suffer, I can take him out! Oh wait, I had to take the boat. Fine. Hold on, I'll walk back. Gosh, it's slow, but I had to take the boat, really? I had to? I can take him out now, everything is okay. Actually, I want to see the other one. Give me the other one. 5058. Now pistol chocobo. I've never actually ridden. I never had the other one. Because I never had the other one. It's just a little. I see. Woofer thing. Roll with it. Hold on, I didn't realize I had to actually take the boat. I just TP'd myself because I was like, it'll be fine. In other words, I just wasted a TP, dang it. Oh god, the bees. Deafening buzzing assaults your ears. Seems to be it. Started the fate if you're not really gonna do it. Or are they doing the fate? know. We'll ride out the circus. We haven't been able to take a mount. I can take mounts now. The game is easier now. I have my mount. Okay, that's good enough for ARR work. No, he thinks so?